that the polarities of all the elements are to be found in the moral and spiritual lives of the individual. And that which constitutes a good life also constitutes an exact working formula for a chemical compound. Now just as surely as man is able to integrate certain patterns in his own living, the laws governing these patterns are exactly the same as those used in architecture. And a happy, harmonious, well-integrated home can be mathematically diagrammed, and the diagram will be the perfect structure for a building. This is what Leonardo meant by certain of his canons. In other words, there is a dynamic which extends from one level of life to another. Pythagoras knew that if you played a certain chord of music, that this chord in its mathematical vibration could be and was equivalent to the basic key to the structure of a building, the basic key to a chemical compound, a basic formula in law, everything. All these things work together constantly. Therefore, if you have a perfect method of purifying a metal, you have a perfect method of purifying a government, a perfect method of purifying a human body, and a human soul, and a human mind. If you can make certain elements work together, you can make certain philosophies work together, certain sciences meet, certain races mingle. All of these things are ruled by the same law. There is one master pattern, which is the great archetype. And all our sciences unfold this archetype. And whatever is true of the individual is true of the collective. Whatever the law is working in nature, it must work in man. And just as surely as certain energies in space unite to produce worlds, so certain energies in man must meet and mingle to produce the development and unfoldment of his body and his functions. There is only one set of laws. And these laws become the keys to the Hermetic art. For the Hermetic art is nothing but the reduction of good intentions to a science. These arts tell you that if you have seven powers of metals in nature, you have seven organs in the body, you have seven glandular structures of importance within the body, you have seven principal orifices in the body, you have seven principal centers in the brain. All of these are tied together by a sympathy. And as you have certain planets in the sky, so you have certain planets in the soul. And as these planets, by their forms, release certain psychic energies and intensities through man, these seven energies have in their turn created the arts and sciences, which are nothing but rationalizations by man along the lines of his own energy. Man is able to build a house and to master architecture because he has a principle of architecture in his own soul. That principle of architecture within his own soul is represented by one of the seven metals. If, therefore, he lacks a certain element within his constitution, he would lack a dimension of consciousness. If gold was removed from his body, he would not only die, but assuming that he did not die, a proportion or dimension of consciousness would depart from him. Every one of these things is tied together, forming one tremendous, all-inclusive pattern. And the pattern itself was described in the Hermetic arts as the tomb of Christian Rosencreuz. For in this tomb was all the symbolism of a miniature universe, and in the ceiling of it burned the ever-burning lamp, which was the symbol of consciousness. As therefore the consciousness in nature produces the world, so the consciousness in man sets up septenaries within himself. These septenaries are all on sympathy with each other, exactly like tuning forks, which at the same pitch will react to the sound one on the other. The same way diseases represent certain perversities in vibratory rates. These diseases can be reached by sounding their keynotes. They can be neutralized by other rates of vibration, representing their antipathies. This was the basis of the sympathetic medicine of Paracelsus. We treated the ailments of Mars with the power of Venus and the ailments of Saturn with the power of Jupiter. But when you say Saturn and Jupiter as planets, you're also referring to elements, to minerals, to medications, the degrees of consciousness, to sense perceptions, to soul perceptions, to intuitional faculties, and to the whole gamut. Because all of these things move on certain vibration patterns. Thus we have in alchemy this concept of one universe, in which a series of formulas exist.
If there must be a new world, let us bring it about, and let us make it a world based upon a foundation of truth, love, and understanding. Let us turn away from the liars, the deceivers, and the manipulators. Seek ye the truth, and the truth shall make you free. And in this message tonight, can be, if you want it to be, the cocoon of a completely different world than those who would enslave us, would bring into being.